So in our last lecture, we completed regarding the mechanism of respiration, in which we had studied about the what kind of respiration occurs in aerobic respiration, and there is a complete oxidation of glucose molecules occur and it releases to form 38 ATPs. While in case of invertebrates as well as in muscle cells, there is an incomplete oxidation and releasing a very small amount of energy in the form of ATP, that is 2 ATP energy are released. But this very small of amount of energy is sufficient for all the lower microbes to do their work. That is why there is no need to derive large amount of energy by the process of respiration in these lower organisms. Instead, they are giving us benefit regarding various industrial processes, we can call, such as beverages industries, baking industries, in which we are using all of these organisms. In sub organisms ko hum use karte hain for the fermentation processes that we have already discussed in our previous lecture. Now we come to the next part of this chapter, what are various respiratory organs, starting from the lower side and moving towards the higher organizations such as human beings. So we start now. So first of all, we should know which is our energy currency. Energy currency kya hota hai? It is adenosine triphosphate. All of you must be hearing this word. Already you must have heard about this word, adenosine triphosphate. Actually, what kind of this chemical molecule is? It is an energy currency of a cell. And if we broadly extended it, then it consists of A, P, P, and again, this is a sigma bond and terminal bond of phosphorus. This bond is joined with the phosphorus, terminal phosphorus carrying large amount of energy. I mean to say, this is a structure of a adenosine triphosphate. Adenosine means it is a adenosine chemical compound, and with the help of this adenosine chemical compound, there are three phosphate groups attached. Three phosphate groups are attached and they can be broken whenever there is a need of energy. One by one they can be broken to release large amount of energy. And whenever there is a need to form the adenosine triphosphate, then we can make it from the adenosine diphosphate. In what manner? Suppose if we are getting ADP, it is a raw material of the ATP. Kiska raw material hai formation ka? ATP formation ka. Whenever we have to form this ATP, which is an our energy currency, then how it is formed? ADP will combine with the inorganic phosphate and it will result to form ATP. And the energy that is formed, that is needed to form the adenosine triphosphate, there is a need of 30.5 kilojoule of energy is required. I mean to say, in this terminal bond, there is a bond energy that is present, it is near about 30.5 kilojoule. Clear? And this raw material, I mean to say, this adenosine diphosphate is again formed from the adenosine monophosphate. This is a diphosphate carrying two groups. Again, if we extend it, this is like this. And again, it is formed from two phosphate group from the adenosine monophosphate by joining of one inorganic phosphate group. Adenosine monophosphate means it is carrying only one phosphate group. We can reverse the direction of these molecules. In molecules ko hum reverse dekhen, toh first of all we are getting adenosine monophosphate jo ki ye wala hai, and whenever we are getting this, this is present in the cell in the form of raw material. Adenosine and phosphate group, when they join with each other, they are forming adenosine monophosphate. And adenosine monophosphate when joined with inorganic phosphate, then they are forming the adenosine diphosphate. Clear? And then adenosine diphosphate will join with one more inorganic phosphate, then it will be forming adenosine triphosphate. And this cycle of making and breaking goes on. What does it mean? Wherever there is a need of energy, the ATP goes to that site, and work is done by utilization of the energy that is provided by this ATP. Is ATP ke dwara jo bhi energy milti hai, wo breaking se milti hai. Kiski? ATP ki breaking se. I mean to say, this process goes on. Synthesis of ATP and breaking of ATP. So that is why we can call ATP is our energy currency. Jahan jahan pe bhi energy ki jarurat hoti hai na, to ATP is transferred from one cell to the another cell. It can be broken or it can be synthesized depending upon the need of organisms. Clear? So this was also present in our yellow box of NCERT, and moreover it is never coming in CBSE examinations, but there was a need to understand it also. That is why I told you. So we come to various respiratory organs. What are various respiratory organs in case of lower organizations? So if we start from the very lower or very primitive organisms such as amoeba. Amoeba mein hum dekhenge na, to what kind of amoeba? All of us know it belongs to phylum protozoa and it is an aquatic organism. So many different species of amoeba we can find all around in the water. Most commonly in the polluted water it is found and causing various diseases to human beings also. But that is a separate issue. First of all, what we should know regarding the respiration, in what manner respiration occurs in amoeba. Previously, we were able to know about the process of nutrition, how nutrition occurs in amoeba, that we have already studied in our previous chapter, previous nutrition wale chapter mein hum padh chuke hain. To ab hum dekhte hain in what manner respiration occurs in amoeba. So there is always a cell membrane and it is extended and form, it can change its direction and it can change its shape. Amoeba can change its shape, it can change its movement wherever it is moving. And in the same manner, whenever oxygen comes in contact with this cell membrane of the amoeba, it is moved inside, because pressure of oxygen is more in aquatic organism, aquatic environment in which amoeba is swimming. Amoeba jahan pe bhi reh raha hai na, wahan par oxygen is maximum. And how it comes inside? Along the concentration gradient and by the process of diffusion. And which is the process? There is a physical process which is called the diffusion. Usko hum kya bolte hain? Diffusion se hi the oxygen passes through the cell membrane of the amoeba and oxygen diffuses inside, and CO2 that is formed due to the activities of the amoeba. So many different works are also performed to sustain its cell body, and CO2 is generated during this process and it is removed outside by the process of diffusion again through the cell membrane. Because we know this time the CO2 is more inside the amoeba. CO2 is more and there is a need to remove it towards outside. Clear? So this is the mode of respiration, or we can say also breathing. There is no clear distinction between breathing and respiration in case of amoeba. Clear? So what happens whenever there is a need of oxygen? Oxygen moves inside through the cell membrane of the amoeba. Is it clear? And CO2 formed, or CO2 is generated due to various cellular activities of amoeba, is removed out again by the process of diffusion through the cell membrane. Clear? So this is a process regarding, we can talk about the in case of amoeba. Now we come to the next organisms, aquatic organisms, and the best example of such kind of aquatic organisms we can take of fish. So many different are also there, and they all, most of the aquatic organisms, they respire through the gills. Different kinds and different shapes and types of gills are present in different species of organisms, but the best example we can take of fish. And in what manner aquatic fish, they take the oxygen, and of course we know there is an opening, or we can say mouth is there, and oxygen is dissolved in water. Again, oxygen is present in water or wherever fishes are present. Fish, they always remain in aquatic water, as we all know, and whenever they are taken out of the water, they can die. So we can say they take their oxygen from the aquatic medium in which they are living, and that aquatic medium may be freshwater sources, or they may be rivers, or they may be ocean, whatever be the condition. But the respiratory organs are always the gill, and the intake of oxygen occurs through the mouth. Kahan se hoti hai? Mouth se. Then we can say when oxygen is taken through the mouth and there are some comb like plate like structures, कुछ लेमिला लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स होती हैं गिल्स की सरफेस पे. गिल्स आर मेड ऑफ सच काइंड ऑफ लेयर लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स, एंड इफ यू टेक दी दिस गिल लाइक स्ट्रक्चर टू दी आउटसाइड, तो वी विल सी लुकिंग लाइक इन व्हाट मैनर दीज गिल लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स दे अपीयर. दीज आर जस्ट गिल प्लेट्स वी कैन से, एंड दीज गिल प्लेट्स आर वेरी स्मॉल एंड इलोंगेटेड हैविंग थिन सेलुलर मेम्ब्रेन, एंड व्हेनेवर ऑक्सीजन इज टेकन इनसाइड इट पासिस थ्रू दिस. Oxygen is passed through this gill surface and taken to the whole body parts by means of various arteries that are present over its surface. Is it clear? And this oxygen, whenever it is distributed to whole body parts, and then CO2 is generated again. Now this CO2 is again dissolved by dissolving in water, comes to the heart and then to the gills, and then it is taken to the outside. So there is a clear distinction on the basis of which we can say that oxygen is taken through the mouth and the CO2 is removed outside through the gill surface, and we call better such kind of gill respiration a brachial respiration. What kind of respiration? It is a brachial respiration. So in fish and other aquatic organism, we should keep in mind a sort of brachial respiration, or we can say respiration occurs through the gill. So we should learn only the word, what kind of respiration occurs in the fishes up to your level, not the method by means of which these fishes they take water. ठीक है, तो gill respiration is there. Now we come to the next organisms. We are better know, all of us we know cockroaches or insects. All the cockroaches or the organism or species that belong to phylum Arthropoda. Arthropoda are invertebrates and pod like segmented bodies, segmented pod structures are there, that we have already known all of the characteristic feature of in our these phylum in Arthropoda in our previous class. So hame malum hai ki why they are called the arthropods, because these are organisms, they are having jointed feet. This is the common name on the basis of which they are belonging to Arthropoda. So most of the insects, they belong to the Arthropoda, and what kind of respiration that occurs inside them. In these organism, respiration occurs through the tubular structure, white shining tubular structure, white tubes that are extended, and they are forming a network like structure all along their surface. Puri ki puri jo tubular structures hoti hai na, they are present all along the surface of these cockroaches, all over the surface, and these are called the trachea. They form a tracheal system, and such kind of tracheal system is called the tracheal respiration. Tubes ko hum kya kehte hain? Trachea. And respiration is called the tracheal respiration, and we can say these trachea, they open to the outside by means of some openings, and these openings are called the spiracles. I mean to say oxygen comes inside in their body through the spiracles, and CO2 goes out through their body to the outside, from their body to the outside through the spiracles. So spiracles are the openings that are present on the sides of their body. Sides pe present hoti hai. Suppose agar hum is tracheal system ko nikale na, to this is, if we want to talk about, this is a spiracle, and network like structure of this tracheal system is present all over the body of their कॉकरोच और अनदर इंसेक्ट्स में ये प्रेजेंट होती हैं, ठीक है। और व्हाट हैपन्स, द रेस्पिरेशन ऑकर्स, ऑक्सीजन मूव्स इनसाइड थ्रू द स्पिरेकल्स एंड इट इज़ पास टू ऑल ओवर दियर बॉडी सर्फेस थ्रू द ट्रेकियल सिस्टम। ट्रेकियल सिस्टम से गई एंड सी ओ टू, ऑक्सीजन इज कमिंग इन साइड एंड सी ओ टू इज ऑल्सो कलेक्टेड फ्रॉम ट्रेकियल ट्यूब टू द एंड इट मूव्स टू द आउटसाइड थ्रू द स्पीरेकल्स। कहाँ से? इन्हीं स्पीरेकल से ये बाहर जाती है जो इनकी बॉडी में है। आई मीन टू से देयर इज ईच एंड एवरी पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी ऑफ द कॉकरोच इज रिसीविंग द ऑक्सीजन, क्लियर, बिकॉज रेस्पिरेटरी ऑर्गन और द ट्रेकियल ट्यूब्स दे आर फॉर्मिंग ए नेटवर्क लाइक स्ट्रक्चर अलॉन्ग ऑल अलॉन्ग देयर सर्फेस, क्लियर। तो दिस इज रिगार्डिंग द ट्रेकियल रेस्पिरेशन। नाउ वी कम टू द नेक्स्ट पार्ट, हाउ डज रेस्पिरेशन ऑकर्स इन केस ऑफ हायर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड देयर इज एन एग्जाम्पल दैट वी कैन टेक ऑफ द ह्यूमन बींग्स। आई मीन टू से वी हैव टू स्टडी इन डिटेल रिगार्डिंग द रेस्पिरेशन दैट ऑकर्स इन हाउ रेस्पिरेशन ऑकर्स इन ह्यूमन बींग। Just before it, one more thing I want to tell you, in lower organizations, there are some more organisms they are left. For example, if we talk about the earthworm, earthworm mein respiration kaise hoti hai? It occurs through the moist skin. Again, it is very important question. It can be asked. Moist skin se hoti hai and such kind of respiration is called the cutaneous respiration. Isko hum kya kehte hain? Cutaneous respiration. Is it clear? Cutaneous respiration is there, brachial respiration is through the gill surface and this is a tracheal respiration that we can take off. In frogs we can take, what happens in case of frog, again moist skin is there for the respiration. Mode of respiration varies, moist skin is there and when the frog is in the tadpole like form, yani ki initial developmental stages mein, there are gills present. And these gills are representing the evolutionary relationship of organisms also. In what manner? They are indicating that the frogs are derived from the fishes. Kahan se? Fishes se derive hume hai. Theek hai na? And then we can say in case of frog, again we can say there is a pulmonary or lung respiration. Lungs respiration in case of adult condition and we can call it pulmonary respiration. So depending upon the need of the oxygen and the circumstances or the environmental conditions in which frog is living, as we all know that frog is amphibian, it is an amphibian, it can live in land as well as on water. Land pe bhi rehta hai aur water mein bhi rehta hai. So whenever it is surviving on the land, then it has to take oxygen from the from where it has to take the oxygen from the air, then lungs are best suiting for this purpose. And inside the water, the respiration can occur through the moist skin. And whenever there is a hibernation occur, whenever frog is in hibernating condition, or we can say it is in winter sleep, then winters mein ye chup jata hai na, nazar nahi aata, and such a process is called the hibernation, jisko hum hibernation bolte hain. So during that case again it can respire through its moist skin, clear. So these are various modes of respiration in different organisms. Now we come to the human being.